This will be lake number 3 of Mike paddleboarding across all 5 Great Lakes. Yeah, it's crazy. We're staying in this like really, really cool cabin situation, and we're right here on the lake. It's been super rainy all morning. Half the property is flooded because it rained so much. It's still raining, so we're just hanging out, drinking some coffee. I think we're going to make some breakfast. And then tomorrow will be the day where Mike will paddle across Lake Superior. It's gonna be cool. That's our week. What's up?
What's up?
I'm getting some vlog content.
No.
Yeah. All right, so it is officially pouring down rain here. We're gonna set up an interview scene for Mike. So, Liana and I are building a scene here. All right, so we just got the interview set up, all ready to roll.
This is my A camera, Fuji X-T4. And then we have over here, this will be like the tight close-up angle. Our key light over here, supporting kind of with the window to light this side of his face. We've got the boom Sennheiser NKE600 running into this guy, which records in 32-bit float. We set up this to make it look really nice. And then we got his rim light back here. And that right there is the setup.
I was constantly going like this, and my feet were freezing, and I knew that I was in trouble. But also, it's a mental game when you're out there.
As of right now, what I'm seeing, and Matt's stuff is kind of telling the same thing, that the wind after this afternoon is supposed to turn tonight southeast. And does it say what time it's supposed to turn?
It looks like 6 a.m., 7 a.m., now it's saying no wind at all. By 10 a.m., there's light wind, like under 5 knots, but it is coming from the northeast. And then by 1, it's still same thing, like under 10 knots northeast, so you stay on the west side of the boat. And then same thing. Yeah, I mean, it's like that the rest of the day.
I would like to see it turn southeast at about 10 tonight, about midnight.
That'd be cool.
Because this lake, even with the wind dying down, this came from 365 miles.
Yeah,
it's gonna keep on rolling.
Right. Yeah.
And like I told you, right now, I think you could probably surf the waves on the west side of the.
Yeah, I hope to tonight.
I don't think anybody's even attempted something like that, but Mike certainly is doing it to raise money and awareness for youth mental wellness.
So today's been a day where we haven't really done a lot of things, but it's definitely been a full day. We did the interview with Mike. We met the boat captain. We did, you know, random things.
Family photos.
Anything.
Oh, we saved a hummingbird's life.
Saved a hummingbird. Yeah. About 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock now. And we're going into town. We're going to get some ice. We're going to like prep things for the boat tomorrow, kind of get our heads and our gear around what we're going to be doing.
If there's some sheep on the field, we might throw Matt into the lake on this surfboard here.
No one knows what you're talking about.
Sheep on the field.
Sheep on the
field. Sheep on the field.
Mean white cats.
Okay, so there's a term that our captain taught us, and it's when there's white caps, like on the water, when there's waves that are white capping, he calls them sheep on the field. So we're going to see if there's any sheep on the field, and if there's sheep on the field, I'm gonna put my feet on a board and try to surf.
Ride those sheep.
Ride those sheep. Ride them.
Yeah. Woohoo!
Sheep come out. Alright, so we just pulled up to the beach, and there are some perfect looking waves. It's a Lake Superior miracle. I never thought I'd get to surf Lake Superior, but here I am. Yeah. You! Dream came true for me today. I got to surf Lake Superior on the 4th of July. We're heading back. We're gonna get prepped for the paddle tomorrow. And
get Mike in bed by 9:30.
Get Mike in bed by 9:30 and have a little bit of dinner time too. Fill our bellies with food.
You're the man, David. It's happening. Okay. Yeah.
Joe will tell you in the morning. Obviously, Joe is the captain, and he's responsible for all of our safety, so that's his number one concern. Like, if someone says, you need to do this,
just do it.
Kind of, like, follow Mike's lead, like, and I want to be closer to the boat, I want to be farther from the boat, he'll let us know. So fuel, we'll either write K for carbolin or E for E-load, or both, a K and an E. Oh, look, we put both. There we go. Check.
What's that?
It's a camera, dude.
Oh, okay.
Oh, we're doing a thing.
Okay. I thought it was a cat.
Mike, you can't stay like this today.
I know, I'm gonna get up. It's happening.
We're good.
Sweet. Alright, it's the morning of. We're on our way to drop Mike off to the beach.
The mouth of the iron.
Then we're gonna head to the marina and get on the boat, and off we go, crossing Lake Superior today.
You'll have me down this place?
be on the other side.
It's super foggy, which is super cool. It's super pretty. I love this kind of scenery. We got 10 to 14 hours ahead of us. These guys just jumped in at the last minute, and they were like, hey, we'll go on the boat with y'all if you need help.
We're excited.
We're on course. We're gonna set the GPS, and we should just have a nice straight line.
Brady has a phone in his hand.
How'd you get roped into this?
It's a blessing. It's a blessing from above.
I started fishing on a port wing in 87. So there's one we got. That was my best one last year.
Woo!
So the salmon got introduced to the Great Lakes because of the eel waves that got dumped in from the salties.
Okay.
They were kind of overtaking Lake Michigan, so the DNR's answer was import Pacific Rum King salmon.
Just one, because you're doing the same thing so frequently. I won't let you go this time.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Go, bass! Have you ever heard it?
No.
You guess what? You're gonna hear it now.
Okay.
Party on a boat!
Mike is making really, really good pace, which is super, super awesome. Weather has improved somehow, so it's gonna be even better than what we thought. We're about to blast music up in this place.
You got a 10-pound bass.
Son, that's a 5-pound bass.
That's a 5-pound bass.
Here we go.
It is the dance
floor. Woo!
Up this morning, come out on the grass. They all knew about the 5-pound bass.
More than halfway. I mean, we're probably 75% of the way done with this crossing. I'm just hanging out in the front of the boat for a little bit. People are listening to music, dancing. Honestly, we've just had a really good time. This has been probably the smoothest crossing so far. Mike has made incredible pace. It's like with each lake, he's just getting better and better. If it wasn't so foggy, we'd be able to see land by now. Still pretty foggy, but the sun is kind of peeking through. It's warm now. It's not super cold. This morning was frigid, but now it's definitely warming up. We're going to be in Two Harbors, Minnesota, 2.5 hours ahead of us or so.
So we could be running 1.8 up here on top, and you're going against the current, and that could be blowing lures right out of the water, running 3.5 or whatever.
Right, yeah.
Well, you go down. So last year there was times when it was 70 degrees on the surface, and I'd go out and fish 90 feet of water, and it'd be 70 all the way to the bottom.
Really?
Optimum temperature for lake trout is 48. Optimum temperature for salmon is 54.
We are about half a mile from the landing point in Minnesota, and the fog has come back in, set in pretty hard. It's gotten really cold, and yeah, it's like 51 degrees. The water's like 41 degrees, so here we are. We're about to land. Mike is killing it, and I think he's ready to be on the beach. Here we are. Even through the fog, we see land. Barely. Crazy choppy right as we're coming into the beach, and Mike
making him work for it.
Yeah, Lake Superior is making Mike work for this at the last like half hour of the paddle.
Okay.
We're ready, let's get it.
Welcome to Two Harbors.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can't rush the art. All right, somehow we've done another crossing where we have to hightail it to the beach again. So me and Leanne are gonna trudge through these geese. And we're gonna get video footage of Mike coming in. Woo! Dude! Lake Superior, man!
That's it! Woo! Number three, baby! Way to go! Way to go!
Yeah!
That last bit was, she got cold, she got angry. She was like, I gave you all day, Mike.
You started this trek about around 7 a.m., a little bit before 7, and you made pretty great time.
No, it was beautiful. It acted up a little bit this afternoon for about an hour. I'm going to calm down. But no, it was my glass out there for most of the day. And
I got you, girl. Look at this boat we got.
Hey, that's amazing.
Woo!
How was it?
Oh.
It was grueling. It was really grueling.
It was an honor. It really was an honor.
Yeah.
I loved it. I had a great time.
This crew has been awesome because, kind of like the last crossing, they just jumped in and was like, hey, we'll go on the boat,
Susie and Randy, they help maintain the hotel that we're staying at, and they were just like, hey, we want to help. They came on the boat, we assembled a team, and here we are. And it was super fun, super beautiful, cold and hot somehow in the same day, crossing 3 out of 5. We got 2 more Great Lakes left, and we will have completed the goal. So now we're gonna head back all the way across Lake Superior to the Wisconsin side. This time we're gonna make some time, man. We're gonna fly on this thing. How fast are we gonna go on this, Joe?
We're gonna run about 20 to 22 miles an hour.
22 miles an hour, and on water that feels like 180 miles an hour. So we're gonna be flying. Super foggy behind us, and then when we get to the marina here, it's just clear as day.
Just a regular day, never even happened.
Yeah.
Wow.
Woo! I trust you, Joe.
Wow.
Amazing. It's like you've done this before.
Want the rope?
Morning. Last night we just kind of hung out after we got the boat unloaded and went to bed pretty early. Everybody was pretty exhausted, and now it is morning time and it's still super foggy. It's been crazy, like 3 full days of just fog around here. I'm actually gonna head home today, get my stuff packed up. Mike and Leanne are gonna stay here one more day, and then that wraps up Lake Superior. Today's a travel day for me. Gotta get home and see my family. For now, I'm gonna try to get some breakfast, get my stuff loaded up, and head home. I'm in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, and I stopped off to try to see Pictured Rock. It's supposed to be like 3 minutes off the course. This is where it took me. This is not Pictured Rock. It's like Pictured Rock is gonna be too far for me to try to visit on this trip home, but I figured I'd just come here. This beach is called Sandy Point. Take a break from the driving and just try to, you know, get some footage, get some photos. Enjoy this for a few minutes before I hop in the car and finish the journey.